What's up, everyone? It's Vapors from Drakemar. Now it's time for another episode of League of Legends. In this episode, we are going to be playing Tristana ADC in a Grand Clown Fiesta. On the enemy team, we have an Elementalist Lux at 11,000 points, a Kai'Sa, a Thresh, a Lee Sin, and an Aurelia. On our team, we have Zed, Void Archer, Adam Dirty Pickle, the Eternum Rek'Sai, a Riven named The Kid 228, the Zed called Void Archer, me called Empress Athandra from my Lord Vaporsmith 1 account, and my support, Braum, being Enigmatic Mystery. And with that, one of my best recent Tristana games.
Welcome to Summoner's Rift. Seconds until minions spawn.
And we're going to be starting with our Braum. We'll put a ward in there. This match actually is pretty insane.
Minions have spawned.
They're doing some kind of level one invade question mark? I think so.
First blood.
Lee Sin gets first blood. Lands a bite. Sin comes again. He tried to stun it. He misses his spear. Thresh actually managed to land. Lee Sin, do not leave me alone. I didn't have to jump you. Lee Sin just is a major problem at this point in the game. And I should get my, try to keep my thing warded and try to stay back. Especially because Lee Sin will like to repeat gank. Because then it makes everything look really bad because this Lee Sin is a problem. But it's very hard sometimes when the Lee Sin has a relationship with his team. So his early damage to is I wanted to freaking 1v1 the Kai'Sa. Riven was flaming the backside. Thresh lands was like a speed in my head. I tried to get for it. Yeah, the last race was to kill the Kai'Sa. Make up for the previous problem before, where we lost and from the Lee Sin Thresh coordination. To get a good still isn't up, but it's worth putting the wall. Kai'Sa lands her void. Big CS difference in the top. Well, it gets big. Right now it's only 20 CS. I'm going to. I'm 2-1 42 farms, 38. I'm getting some tank speed. And I'm getting. Yeah, so. Void Archer dies to Lux. And Riven manages to kill on the I think with ultimate. I think Riven decided the time had come that all in to come up. Games, it's going to be over. try to get the kill on the Lux, unfortunately, because... Zed gets a kill. He's been bugging me all game. Braum is a pretty good support. To get my Infinity Edge now, and a Zeal, and some more
turret
crits,
because
the crit item, this is patch 9.3 when I'm recording this, so the crit items are now back the way they used to be, which was the Infinity Edge gives you flat crit, and the Storm Razor got reworked, so now Infinity Edge is really good again. I target Kai'Sa because I know that Kai'Sa is a big threat, especially in the game. So that's why I was targeting Kai'Sa instead of Thresh. Because I've had some bad experiences in the late game. I try to get some damage on. their turret's gone, which is good. Unfortunately, they're taking on the CS. We are looking for a dive. Shut down the place. 5-3-5. Things are not looking as good, especially since Kaiser got another kill. Aurelia gets killed straight onto the. I got a Vampiric Scepter that I'm going to be eventually turning into Bloodthirster, but I'm keeping it for the bonus lifesteal. I like how the Muffin Squad, the Lux is called the Muffin Squad. I'm gonna get another BF sword. Get some more damage. And, unfortunately, Braum dies to the Thresh. And Rek'Sai dies to the Sun. Oh, and if you're asking whether or not this game is going to last a long time, it is. It's quite a long game, actually. It's just not a game, believe it or not. Put a control over there. There's a point where we all lose this game. Braum is 1-2 and 10, but his score gets a lot easier as time goes on. He don't have to.
Dominating.
Double kill. So now I'm 8, 4, and 5, so I'm getting more kills now. I'm going to... getting more items. I'm getting... more crits. Trying to decide. Oh yeah, the recipe for Phantom Dancer has changed. So I'm probably building towards Phantom Dancer with a flat health shield. Because it now, in this patch, it gives a flat health shield. That shield would be very valuable on Tristana, since she would probably kill. The build is very high damage, but it's not. A lot of bad stuff happens. They come towards Baron. They're pointing that Rek'Sai could steal the Baron. That fight went very badly for us, but well for them.
Rampage.
He sends off. And our Zed steals Baron. Which is actually pretty incredible.
Shut down.
And our Zed gets a shutdown. Mostly because I have Phantom Dancer. She managed to land a full combo. I got Bloodthirst right now.
Blue team's turret has been destroyed.
Braum gets a turret. I mean, he's 1-4 and 13, which is not too bad. I mean, he's helped me in the lane phase, too. He got me dead, so that's good. I'm gonna go try to help him. Sometimes it's hard because the problem with damage is in the late game. 12, 5, and 7. gotta stay by Braum at this stage of the game. Getting this farm and being alone because this is around here.
Red team's turret has been destroyed.
Unfortunately, Lux and Zed go for a 1-4. Our Revan gets a kill out of the Kaisa. And unfortunately, another Zeal and Kindleshaw into boots. I actually buy boots, interesting. Because I don't usually buy boots. Yeah, this game is long, because when it gets to the point where I can buy boots, like, where I want to buy boots, then you know the game is either I'm thinking about buying boots for a specific reason, or the game is a long game. One or the other. Shorty Black Lotus is slain by 2-2-8. Unfortunately, he's probably the blast plan. Game isn't even entirely over.
New team's turret has been destroyed.
Game still has not ended, but I am legendary. 17-5. North of 1,000 gold. I got racked by and some and a complete pair of Berserker's Greaves. Good old Void Archer gets to kill him with the Muffin Squad. If you're asking why I try to throw the mine on the first time, I've been in the late game for Garo, Tristana has to combo. And Braum wasn't there to try to save me. I get GA thinking it's a good item at this stage of the game, obviously. 32 minutes in. Team fights are getting murkier. Death timers are getting a lot longer, so it's getting a lot dicier. And we still have an entirely cracked base. We haven't cracked our base. End the game. Try to kill him. Triple kill. Really slows the game when you could Dark Side doesn't survive, which I'm not sure if you. I get the armor points that I get execution spot as well. So I'm trying to get more light steam. Gotta help out with Baron. Unfortunately, I think Baron. See, some games I have so long, there's so many throws.
Unstoppable.
But she was. I still have some of the highest farm in the game, which tells you how little people
dominating.
How little they farm in here. Somehow Lucid's dominating.
Blue team has slain the dragon.
Kai'Sa is on a 3-item power spike, but I'm on my 4, I'm approaching 5, 6 items. Take out these CS. Still like the landscape.
Godlike.
Somehow. Get to some basic attacks on Kai'Sa. Somehow she's still no HP. Killed by the frickin' Thresh.
Shut down. Killing spree.
Get more of a reminder. Thresh is somehow on a killing spree. I try to encourage my team not to surrender. It's very hard to get this team to fight. Braum now has 9 deaths.
Aced.
Leasing gets an ace.
Red team's turret has been destroyed.
But Zed revives to defend. And as Zed gets a kill on the Lux Muffin Squad. That's your 10th death.
Red Team's inhibitor has been destroyed.
Unfortunately, the Kaisa's score has somewhat improved. Despite the fact I ate.
Red Team's turret has been destroyed.
Which is, Lee Sin is almost 18. He's worth it. Without using ulti, thankfully, because I need to save my ulti for her. So it's 40 minutes in, we still haven't managed to end the game. Everyone has, my team, has some very serious doubts about whether or not we can end the game, and whether or not it's possible. With 100 kills in 40 minutes.